You're watching Tag TV.
Hello and welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a program that exposes Pakistan's role and nexus in promoting global terrorism and its funding. Here are the headlines. Terror attack on minority Sikhs and Hindus in Afghanistan condemned. Pakistan faces criticism at UN for sponsoring terrorism and violating human rights. LAT chief Hafiz Saeed vows to join mainstream politics in Pakistan. And Pakistan remains adamant on terror despite FATF grey list. Terror attack on members of the minority Sikh and Hindu community in Afghanistan has been widely condemned by people in Afghanistan and other parts of the world. A suicide bombing claimed by ISIS killed at least 19 people in Jalalabad. We have a report.
A terrorist detonated his vest at a gathering of Hindus and Sikhs who were on their way to meet the Afghan President Ashraf Ghani in Jalalabad. The Islamic State claimed responsibility, saying they targeted the members of the minority community as they were deemed of polytheists. Among the 13 members of minority community killed was Sikh leader Avtar Singh Khalsa, who was travelling by car to meet the Afghan president when he died. Avtar was planning to run in the country's parliamentary elections in October. Many among Afghanistan's dwindling Sikh minority are considering leaving for neighboring India, where a majority of Afghan Sikh and Hindus have taken shelter. The Shiromani Gurudwara Prabandhak Committee, SGPC, the apex body of the Sikh shrines, strongly condemned the attack and urged the government to ensure safety of the minorities.
ਮਾਰੇ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਜਿਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਾਰੇ ਸਿੱਖਾਂ ਦੇ ਹਿਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਉਹ ਲੁੰਦਰੇ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਮੈਂ ਸਮਝਦਾ ਕਿ ਸਿੱਖ ਐਸੀ ਕੌਮ ਹੈ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਸਿੱਖ ਵੱਸਦੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੀ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਔਰ ਆਪਣੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਪਹਿਚਾਣ ਆਪ ਬਣਾਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਦੇਸ਼ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਮੈਂ ਸਮਝਦਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਤਰੱਕੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਯੋਗਦਾਨ ਆਪਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਸੋ ਇਸ ਲਈ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਰਕਾਰਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਜਾਨ ਮਾਲ ਦੀ ਰਾਖੀ ਕਰਨ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਹਿਫਾਜ਼ਤ ਕਰਨ
ਇਟਸ ਵੈਰੀ ਸ਼ੌਕਿੰਗ ਇੰਕਲੂਡਿੰਗ ਦ ਲਾਸ ਆਫ ਉਤਾਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਵਾਜ਼ ਦ ਕੈਂਡੀਡੇਟ ਫੋਰ ਦ ਅਪਕਮਿੰਗ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਐਨ ਅਟੈਕ ਔਨ ਦ ਅਫਗਾਨ ਡੈਮੋਕ੍ਰੇਸੀ ਅਟੈਕ ਔਨ ਦ ਅਫਗਾਨ ਵੈਲਿਊਸ ਫਰੀਡਮ ਆਫ ਰਿਲੀਜਨ ਫੇਥ ਐਂਡ ਅਟੈਕ ਔਨ ਆਵਰ ਡਾਇਵਰਸਿਟੀ
Members of the Sikh community staged a protest in front of the Afghan embassy in New Delhi and condemned the terror attack in Afghanistan. Indian Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj also met with the family members and relatives of the victims in New Delhi. They discussed about the security of the community members in Afghanistan, passport-related issues about funding education of Sikh orphans in Afghanistan and providing compensation to the family members of the victims.
हम ये चाहते हैं कि उनको अगर उनकी पासपोर्टों में प्रॉब्लम है आने की दिक्कत है टिकट की दिक्कत है ये सारी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व की
सिक्योरिटी सिचुएशन हैज डिटीरियोरेटेड इन अफगानिस्तान सिंस आफ्टर द अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ द प्रेसिडेंशियल पोल्स इन द कंट्री द तालिबान एंड द आईसिस हैव कैरिड आउट मेनी टेरर अटैक्स ऑन वोटिंग रजिस्ट्रेशन सेंटर्स एंड असैसिनेटेड इलेक्शन ऑफिशियल्स More than 100 civilians and security force personnel have been reported killed since April 1st as a result of this violence. Many of these fatalities occurred in a single event, where 69 people were reportedly killed and 120 were injured in a bombing claimed by the IS at a voting center in Kabul on 22nd April. With almost 4 months remaining for the elections, the Afghan government has a challenge to convince the citizens about holding free and fair elections and safeguarding them while doing so.
Moving on, Pakistan has been facing strong criticism for sponsoring terrorism and violating human rights in the country. During the ongoing 38th session of the Human Rights Council in Geneva, a strong voice has been raised against Pakistan for perpetrating violence and persecution of political activists. Newsweek South Asia has a report.
Terrorist sanctuaries still prevail inside Pakistan as its security agencies fail to eliminate the dreaded monsters. It is alleged that many of these terror groups enjoy the patronage of Pakistan's secret agencies and the army. The terrorists are being used as proxies to carry out activities in neighboring India. During the ongoing 38th session of the Human Rights Council in Geneva, India lambasts on Pakistan for spreading terror in Jammu and Kashmir.
The real problem in the state of Jammu and Kashmir is terrorism, which has constantly received sustenance from Pakistan and territories under its control, having diverted billions of dollars in international military and development aid towards creating a dangerous infrastructure of terror on its own territory. Pakistan is now speaking of its achievements. We urge the Council to call on Pakistan to end cross-border infiltration, to dismantle special terrorist zones, safe havens and sanctuaries, to take verifiable actions on terror financing, to provide freedom to the people of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir by ending its illegal and forcible occupation.
Not only India, but people living within Pakistan suffer in the hands of terrorists and secret agencies. In Balochistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Sindh provinces of Pakistan, the cases of enforced disappearances, torture and killings are increasing rapidly. People are protesting on streets to decry the government and security agencies for violating human rights and perpetrating violence. They now seek justice by carrying out protests across Pakistan.
Pakistani establishment is ruthlessly crushing every voice and struggle of Sindhi people against the cruel loot and occupation of resources, lands, pushing them into perpetual poverty, malnutrition, social injustice and disease. Additionally, the state is ruthlessly pursuing construction of multi-billion project China-Pak Economic Corridor CPEC without any consideration of rights of indigenous Sindhi people and the environment. Pakistani state has been using enforced disappearances of human rights and political activists as a tool to silence Sindhi people for the last several years.
I would like to draw the attention of the Human Rights Council to the violations of fundamental human rights in Pakistan. The establishment of Pakistan led by army is just looting and plundering national resources, and anyone dares to raise voice against the violations of human rights is sent silenced by the use of brutal state force. The general elections in Pakistan are announced for 25 July 2018. These are fake elections with only the favorite parties of the Pakistan establishment are allowed to participate. The most secular and liberal voice of the middle class in Pakistan, Mr. Altaf Hussain, founder and leader of the MQM, is facing an embargo in Pakistan. Media is not allowed to air his voice or picture, thus denying him his right to freedom of speech. All the offices of MQM are sealed. Thousands of MQM workers are killed extrajudicially. Thousands are languishing in state safe houses. Incarceration of Muhajir localities by brutal paramilitary rangers is the order of the day. Without any court orders, Muhajir houses are raided and anyone can be kidnapped and kept in the safe houses for the notorious ISI. Mr. Chairman, military operation is going on in 3 out of 4 provinces in Pakistan. The elections has been boycotted by MQM and I therefore request humbly to Honorable High Commissioner for Human Rights to send a fact-finding mission to Pakistan and make the report public. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
We want justice! We want justice! We want justice!
The people living in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir have also blamed Islamabad for its malicious designs to exploiting natural resources and eliminating those who are raising voice for their rights. A large number of political activists in POK and Gilgit-Baltistan have been booked falsely under the Anti-Terrorist Act. Many of these activists are missing for months and years. Political activists from POK now urge the United Nations to send a fact-finding team in the region and expose Pakistan's misrule.
We urge upon HCR to include following grave human rights violations in the report, which are carried out by the law enforcement agencies of Pakistan with impunity, enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings, and victimization of Kashmiri nationalists. In May 2013, the Arab Shahid chairman of All Parties National Alliance, one of the prominent Kashmiri nationalist politicians, was assassinated at Rawalpindi, Pakistan. This issue several times raised at different forums, including HRC, to put pressure on Pakistan to constitute a judicial inquiry into target killing of Arif Shahid, but no action has taken yet.
Pakistan has been facing worldwide condemnation for its support to terrorists and violations of human rights, but the government and security forces fail to work for world peace and stability.
Moving on, Pakistan not only allows safe haven to terror outfits, but provides space for dreaded terrorists to take part in the general elections. The Mumbai terror attacks mastermind Hafiz Saeed has placed almost 265 candidates for the general elections 2018. Experts believe his side's organization is backed by Pakistan Army, who wish to establish a puppet government at the center. We have a report.
Meet Hafiz Saeed, a known global terrorist who is freely campaigning for his candidates contesting general elections in Pakistan. Mumbai terror attacks mastermind Hafiz Saeed, who has a bounty of $10 million, has fielded his son and son-in-law among the 265 candidates for the elections. They are contesting on the platform of a little-known dormant political entity, Allahu Akbar Tehreek.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Hamare raviye bhi kahenge Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Aur inshallah is mission ke saath Pakistan ke gali koochon se awaaz buland hogi Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Hafiz Saeed is trying to woo votes by spreading venom against India and the United States.
Afghanistan mein baith ke India ne America ki shahkar Balochistan ke liye jo planning ki hai Pakistan se kaatne ke liye jo surat-e-haal paida ki hai Ukada ke bhaiyo saathiyo naujawano Ukada ke leader hazrat shayad aap bahut kam waqif hain. आपने सिर्फ मीडिया से खबरें सुनी होंगी, सुनी सुनाई बातें. ओ भाई, ये आपका भाई जो बोल रहा है, मैंने अल्लाह के फजल और करम से बलूचिस्तान का चप्पा चप्पा छाड़ मारा. क्या हो रहा है यहाँ? कौन लोग क्या कर रहे हैं? किस तरह की तहरीकें उठ रही? इंडिया के एजेंट यहाँ क्या कर रहे हैं? अलेप्पी की तहरीकें किस तरह मुनज्जम हो रही?
As the polling date is approaching, experts are raising concern over growing influence of military and terrorists in the elections.
It is a very good thing that the Pakistani media is increasingly beginning to caution its own people about the dangers to Pakistani nation and Pakistani society from terrorist organizations, particularly of the variety of Hafiz Saeed. GOTV, Dawn newspaper and all of the newspaper editors in their editorials are telling the people that the greatest cause of misery for Pakistan today, tomorrow and potentially is because Pakistan is allowing organizations like Hafiz Saeed's organization and other organizations like Al-Qaeda, Taliban, etc. to operate absolutely freely from its soil. And it is because of them that Pakistan has become increasingly isolated, increasingly being scoffed at, increasingly being economically tortured, and may eventually be a cause for Pakistan's breakup.
Various countries, including India, have expressed in discontentment over Hafiz Saeed's entity being mainstreamed in Pakistan. However, the deep state of the army, which seems to backing up Hafiz Saeed, has been successful in bringing him to the fore. It is being speculated that Nawaz Sharif's PMLN might make a strong comeback, but Pakistan Army and the ISI are backing Saeed to field his candidates.
It appears that the current election in Pakistan, July 25th, is likely to be a contest between the party of former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and somebody who's been waiting in the wings for a long time to become Prime Minister of Pakistan, that is the cricketer turned politician Imran Khan, and the party that he heads, the PTI. Indicators from the ground seem to suggest that there is a large cross section that is still supportive of Mr. Nawaz Sharif and his party. But again, at the end of the day, it's going to be a numbers game. And if the Pakistani army and military are determined to deny Mr. Nawaz Sharif and his party the kind of electoral legitimacy, I think then we would see a situation where people not only like Mr. Imran Khan, but also leaders like, and when I say leaders, I mean terror group leaders, like Hafiz Saeed and the leader of the Lashkar-e-Jhangvi, among others, may be given some kind of space.
Recently, Pakistan had been humiliated by the FATF and has been getting repeated warnings from Washington to control the terror groups originating from this soil. Yet, they have allowed party of terrorists like Hafiz Saeed to contest polls. Experts believe that it is high time to declare Pakistan as a terror nation.
The Financial Action Task Force, FATF, the international watchdog, recently put Pakistan back on its grey list as it has failed and also refused to take control of the terror organizations that come out of their soil. India, which has been on the receiving end of Pakistan's terror activities, applauded the FATF for the decision. But Pakistan has decided not to take the decision seriously. Newsweek South Asia has a report.
Victim of Pakistan-sponsored terrorism for decades, India has welcomed the decision of the FATF to put Pakistan in its grey list. Be it the Haqqani network, Al-Qaeda and the Taliban, several terror outfits are operating from Pakistani soil which are responsible for regional instability. Many of them are being financed by Islamabad with an aim to use them as proxies against neighbouring India and Afghanistan. Even the United States said that the Taliban's failure to engage in talks was totally unacceptable and called on Pakistan to put more pressure on terrorists. US envoy Alice Wells made those remarks while on her visit to South Asia.
Pakistan has found temporary means to overcome this problem. There are reports that China has already given them $1 billion dollars. Pakistan is facing problems because of current account deficit, and they want some temporary relief either from the world bodies or from friendly countries to overcome this. So China has already helped them, and there are reports that even Saudi Arabia will help them. And thereafter, they are going to wait till the time the elections get over so that the elected government thereafter can negotiate with the world bodies to take them off from the FATF list.
Recently, a delegation led by Pakistani Interim Minister for Finance and Planning, Dr. Shamshad Akhtar, appraised the global watchdog of steps taken by Pakistan to stifle terror financing and money laundering. But it failed to convince the FATF for adequate steps taken by the government to eradicate terror from its soil. India praised the decision of the FATF and expressed hope that Pakistan would learn a lesson. We hope that the FATF action plan shall be compiled within a time-bound manner and credible measure would be taken by Pakistan to address global concerns related to terrorism emanating from any territory under its control, the Indian Ministry of External Affairs said. The United States has already announced aid cuts to Pakistan for its lack of cooperation in tackling the Haqqani network. In particular, the spotlight is on Hafiz Saeed-led Jamaat-ud-Dawah and Falah Insaniyat Foundation that operates in the country. Experts say this decision will affect the Pakistani economy in an extremely negative way. But they will manage to overcome the phase through illegal ways and through their friends.
Pakistan had been put in the grey list earlier also for nearly a period of 3 years. But it simply had no effect on it because it used all other means to get around the FATF sanctions. So therefore, FATF sanctions by itself are not going to be sufficient. We must ensure that they are put on the red list. We must ensure that the world economically boycott them. And we must ensure as a final measure that Pakistan, like Korea and Iraq, and Iran, is declared as a terrorist state so that the whole world starts putting pressure on them to stop aid to terrorism.
Pakistan had tried to eyewash the FATF members before the decision, which came last week. Hours before the FATF was to meet, Pakistan lifted the ban on a Sunni extremist outfit, Ahl-e-Sunnat Wal Jamaat, and unlocked assets of its chief, Maulana Ahmed Ludhianvi. The order was issued by the Pakistan National Counter-Terrorism Authority. The removal came as a surprise as international pressure mounts on Pakistan to act against terror groups. Some members of this group would be contesting the forthcoming elections for both provincial and national assembly. The amendment of the anti-terror legislation through an ordinance is to include all designated individuals and groups in the national listing of prescribed outfits and persons. But yet, Pakistan refuses to fall in line and accept the reality.
Pakistan is not only responsible for spreading terrorism in India, but other parts of the world too. And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We will be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Uzma Jafri signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.
You're watching Tag TV.